Welcome back to mathematicsclass.org, and we're going to be looking at a new past paper. This is the January 2020 CSET Mathematics past paper. It was done on January 6th. So you have the paper itself here, which I had scanned. Copy of it. You have all the sections that you should fill out. Your instructions. You must read the instructions always. It says this paper consists of two sections, one and two. Section one has 7 questions and section two has 3. Answer all questions. You should write your name in the spaces provided in this booklet. Do not write in the margins. All work must be clearly shown. You have a list of formula on page 4. If you need to rewrite any answer and there's not enough space to do so on the original page, you use extra papers provided at the back of this booklet and draw the line through your original answer, that which you omitted, right? And if you use extra pages, you must write the question number clearly in the box provided at the top of the extra pages where relevant. Include the question part beside the answer. Okay. And you require an electronic calculator. That's a scientific calculator, right? Not programmable, but a scientific calculator, and your geometry set. Okay, you have your formula sheet here, and then question one will start. But before question one starts, just a quick reminder, with this, as I recommend, and with other paper, with your upcoming paper, right? What I recommend that you do is to take the first 10 minutes to read over the question, starting from the hardest. You have 2 hours and 40 minutes would be what? 2, 6, 12, 120 plus 40, that's going to be 160 minutes to do. How many questions is it now? 10, right? 10 questions. So just take a glance at it. It's the back there after the last question. I'm going up extra space. All right. So 10, question 10 is on vectors and matrices. You know, the usual topics that always come. You have geometry and trigonometry, alright? And you have question, that was question 9, and then question 8, algebra, relation, functions and graph. You just quickly take a look at those questions from back to front. And the idea is that you, when you read these harder questions, you have your subconscious mind thinking about them while you're doing the questions, the easier questions, starting from question one. So you have up to question 6, not labeled. question 6 is not labeled as any particular topic. Well, let's look at what happens in question 7, right? Question 7 isn't labeled either as belonging to any particular topic. Right, so question 1 to 7 is in section 1. Those are in section 1. Then section 2 is where question 8 starts. So you have 8, 9, and 10 in section 2. But you don't have an option. You have to answer all questions in section 1 and all questions in section 2 as well. Alright? So you take the first 10 minutes to read through these questions. And then after 10 minutes, you have 150 minutes remaining. So 10 minutes are gone. You have 150 minutes remaining. So this essentially gives you 15 minutes per question, right? 15 minutes per question. You have to watch the clock now. You could give yourself all 15 minutes per question, but that does not give you the chance to go back to finish any question that you may not have completed. What you could also do is give yourself 10 minutes per question so that you don't spend the entire time struggling with a question that you can do when other questions that you could do are waiting for you and you didn't get the chance to do them. Alright? So you could give yourself 10 minutes per question. And then you will have 50 minutes extra left over when you reach question 10. Whatever you didn't finish on a question, you would leave a space, then you come back to it. During that last 50 minutes, you would come back to finish up whatever work you didn't finish up, all right? So if you give yourself 10 minutes per question, that's how it would work. So what happens if the exam starts at 9? So at 9 o'clock, you start. You read. Then at 9:10, or the first 10 minutes, you read at 9:10 to 9:20 is question 1. That's if you give yourself 10 minutes per question. From 9:20 to 9:30, that's question 2. From 9:30 to 9:40, that's question, all of this gap, that's question 3, right? From 9:40 to 9:50, question 4, from 9:50 to 10 o'clock, question 5, so remember, from 9 o'clock, you have 2 hours and 40 minutes, you know. So those 2 hours and 40 minutes is the total time that you would have in the exam. So matching that time to what we'll be doing, right, it's 2 hours and 40 minutes. You see it there. So from, you would go from 9:10, 11:40. So up to 11:40, you aim at finishing at 11:40, all right? So from 9 to 11:40 is all the time you have. So as I say, 9 to 10 you read over. 9 to 9:10, 9:10 to 9:20 question 1, 9:20 to 9:30 question 2, 9:30 to 9:40 question 3, 9:40 to 9:50 question 4, 9:50 to 10 o'clock question 5. Then from 10 to 10:10. That's question 6. So you keep moving. You keep moving like that. Then from 10:10 to 10:20, question 7, from 10:20 to 10:30, question 8, 10:30 to 10:40, question 9, 10:40 to 10:50. You have question 10. Done. That means you've been doing the questions. When you see the 10 minutes up, you stop, leave a space, and move on to the next question. You keep doing that if you take the 10 minutes per question formula or that method. At 9:50, you would reach question 10. Then you have from 9:50 to 10:40 to go back to finishing up whatever work you had left out. Alright? That will ensure that you touch every question and you did not waste time struggling over a question, a hard question that you couldn't do. You make efficient use of the time. All right. Now, we're going to be looking at question 1. What we'll do is just leave that out for a new video. All right. And then the next video in this series for this past paper is going to be starting to do question 1. We'll start to do question 1. All right, so I will see you then.